Great excitement again, Martin. Tremendous skill from Kelly. The ball fell to Barrow. It could just easily have went in the back of the net.
Well, Tony Kelly could have been a wasted talent. Wigan Athletic have brought him back into the fold. And Kelly, already with one goal under his belt, is playing his part in a quite superb final. And here's Salma, and here go Brentford again. Knowles sliding it away. Two sides with attacking ideals, providing real enjoyment for a crowd who are sitting in the sunshine and giving the game the right sort of support. It's a day of friendship and for families, and it's a day for fine football as well. All credit to Craig Rover, who saw the potential of this type of tournament. A perfect scene. The prices here, the top price is only £8 for the best seat. So everyone encouraged to come and perhaps take a view of a match at Wembley that they might not be able to afford for an international or an FA Cup final. Salmon. Methven tussling away. Here's Miller. Look, an uphill struggle for Brentford now. They're looking to climb that hill. Hurlock. To let it run, and Yule was snapping away at him. And Wigan have a free kick. Wignall, I think, more an arm raise, an apology to his teammates for his misjudgment. Both sides in the second half attacking the goals behind which their supporters have grouped. And Brian Hamilton looking quite relaxed as Brentford make a substitution. Terry Bullivant, a midfield player, who was actually in the Aston Villa squad when they won the First Division Championship, although he didn't get much first-team action that season. It's Bob Booker who's going off. And maybe they'll be pushing Keith Castles further forward and letting Bullivant, who has a quality touch in his passing, try and get a grip on midfield. We shall see. Kelly takes the free kick for Wigan. And Barrow can't get it across the face of the goal, and his real problem was a teammate, Steve Walsh, who perhaps should have called louder. So Terry Bullivant on with half an hour to go. That's if the match doesn't go to extra time, of course. Needs two Brentford goals for that to happen. But from what we've seen so far, that's not out of the question. But here's Kevin Langley, covering a lot of ground from midfield. Methven. And it looks, Lou, as though Castles is going forward now.
Well, he's got experience with Southampton of playing up there, and Frank will be looking for great things from him now, especially 3-1 behind.
Nice back heel from Roberts. Kamara's cross. Harlock went for it, hell for leather. Here's Wignall. Wigan trying to push out. And Roberts might have got behind Methven. Well, in the southern area final, he put four chances away that were harder than that one.
As he got on the end of this, he nicely stayed onside, and as the ball bounced, I thought it was going to be another classic goal for Wembley, but it just wasn't to be.
So Castle's an out-and-out striker up alongside Cook. And his goal-scoring record, 45 in 168, which is a reasonable return. Some of those scored in the First Division. Up above Castles, a former Wembley player with the non-league club, just a mile or so away from here, as indeed was this man, Gary Roberts, and the two combine. Cridley halts them in their tracks. And Brentford send Wignall forward. Barrow has to come back to cover that area around the near post. He's marking the space there that Brentford might be trying to fill with a late run. Kamara, you can be sure, will want to attack it if it comes his way. It was Millen who met it. Out from Methven. And of course, as Brentford commit more and more men forward, they're always vulnerable at the back. Here's Lowe. The header was aimed for Langley. Wigan had five men forward then.
Yes, they're beginning to pour men forward now, Martin, and Brentford just need to watch out in the anxiety to get goals at the other end. They're leaving a few gaps at the back.
Hurlock. Terry Hurlock was getting married, and he was hoping for a sequence of two Saturdays to remember, one after another, as the Brentford captain, to perhaps get his hands on the Freight Rover trophy. But it may not be, although I'm sure he will be leading the fight in the 26 minutes that remain. Cridley staying so close to Roberts. Wigan taking off Gary Bennett, and to add to the flavour of a day for young people, here's 17-year-old Warren Aspinall. But he's a very confident 17-year-old. He took the winning penalty in the Northern Area final against Mansfield, and he's also already taken successfully a penalty in the Third Division. And he's only played 10 league games. Possession and a good advantage played by Tom Bune. Barrow jumping clumsily. Free kick against him. Walsh. Barrow trying to take it on the run, and Wignall just there ahead of Mike Newell. Salmon. Nicely taken by Castles. There was quality in that. And Cribley denies Cook from the cross. That was an encouraging sign for Brentford, Lou.
Yes, tremendous skill by Keith Castles, and that's what we expect from him. He hasn't done it too much this game.
Murray. Roberts. And Bullivant. As he was challenged by Kelly. Terry Bullivant started his league career with Fulham. Aston Villa paid £200,000 for him, and then he moved on to Brentford via Charlton. He's really suffered from injuries in recent seasons. And this year's had a hernia operation, and he just recovered from it. Play his part for Brentford towards the end of the season. Well, that's handball by Newell, and that time the referee didn't miss it. One thing that is impressing me, Lou, is the way that the players are lasting the pace.
Yes.
On a very warm afternoon indeed.
It's normally the last 20 minutes though, Martin, at Wembley that gets to you.
I thought you were going to tell me it was the quality of the fitness training in the third and fourth divisions.
Well, that's one thing, but Brentford have been to Cyprus, don't forget, and I don't think that's done them much good.
Well, they have a free kick here, and they badly need a second goal. Methven. More happy to let it run. Here's Cook. Kamara. They're trying to reposition in the middle. It's Hurlock trying to reach it, and Salmon, actually scored against Wigan in the league meeting at Griffin Park back in September. But it wasn't to be then.
Just noticed, Martin, Chris Kamara, who is a very fit player, already has got his stockings round about his ankles, and he's probably feeling the pressure already.
Taking off some of the pressure on the calves. Here is Kamara. Tidied up again by Methven. Murray into the back of Aspinall. The three-quarter mark now. Wigan still lead 3-1. Paul is the jewel in Wigan's crown. Well, Paul Jewell is the other Wigan substitute who hasn't been called upon yet. Paul Jewell waits and wonders whether he'll get the feel of the Wembley turf. On the left of the two. I am a firm believer that the third and fourth divisions have an important role to play in the pyramid of the Football League. So much talk about going part-time, but the breeding ground for first division players it is, and full-time training is such an important thing for young players at this level, and we're seeing the benefits of that in the way the players are lasting the pace here. Kamara. Salmon. It was an awkward run for Hurlock. There was a heavy collision between two of these strong midfield men, Kelly and Hurlock, ending happily with a handshake. And Terry Bullivant to take the free kick. That's a Methven just there before Wignall. Kelly almost turning into trouble. Newell. Barrow. That's been all who should be the fittest out there, really. He's been on the shortest time. Perhaps there is a sign of tiredness. A piece of miscontrol from Kamara. Kelly with a breaking pass. It was aimed for Lowe, who then obstructed Salmon. Walsh, who's missed little in the air. Hurlock. There's Kamara. Cook has been lively for Brentford. They haven't quite got the ball to him as often as they would like. Tucks a catch under no pressure. Castle's trying to force a way through the middle. Langley got a foot in. Barrow. And back from Bullivant. Well, whether you're watching from the Royal Box or from any part of the stadium, it's been a sight to behold, this match, and maybe still more to come. Well, Lou, it would be easy for Wigan to think about sitting on this two-goal lead, but...
Well, I think they were quite content to do that, Martin. Brentford are running out a little bit of steam. There's not many people going to get forward now. Robbie Cook put his socks around his ankles as well.
Here's Lowe. Outside him goes Knowles, ahead of him goes Newell. And we're going to have the throw. I'm happy to see the ball down in that corner. Newell. And Newell and Newell in a tangle. The ball safely away for Brentford. A nice turn from Cook. Kelly is covering. Almost puts Castles through. Methven, the old campaigner, rescued the impetuosity of youth. Newell. Barrow. Faced by Millen. It was a rather weary effort, trying to pivot quickly. To Wigan, and Brentford might feel they've been harshly treated in a couple of ways. First of all, by the manner of the first goal, when Mike Newell handled first, and then having got back to 2-1 before they'd really settled, Frank McClintock's side conceded a third goal. His assistant on the left, John Doherty. Cook. 15 minutes left. Have Brentford got the reserves of energy to really take it away from Wigan now? Roberts with another tantalising piece of skill as he drove the cross in low towards Cook on the near post. Roberts. Stern defensive work again from Walsh. Kelly has seen the attacking options when they've been there for Wigan. Aspinall, and Kelly again. The goalkeeper went back on his line. And Kelly, I think, would have liked the goalkeeper coming towards him, Lou, if he could have looped the ball over him.
Yes, he got in there again well. You know, you can tell he's been at a higher grade. I think you said he'd been with Liverpool before. He's getting forward frequently now, whereas one of his opponents, Terry Hurlock, who is very fit, he's actually stopped running.
Hurlock, though, with the spring to reach the header there. And Castles felt more angry with himself than with Gary Roberts, although he was waving at Roberts for not going further forward. now the two. Try and put things right. But Brentford have got to come up with a solution fairly quickly. Low. Put out by Cribbley. Well, Jamie Murray to take the free kick. Cook. And ball, it was ball to hand. A shot from Wignall. And the referee was well placed. Barrow onside, and here's Aspinall. And the 17-year-old wanted a Wembley goal of his own. But that is Warren Aspinall. There'll be no inhibitions from him.
Go from one end where we thought we'd have a penalty kick, we go straight to the other end. That's typical of this game. And how fitting a game it would have been if the young 17-year-old had scored.
Here he is again. Langley. Newell making runs off the ball ahead of him, and then that's again tiredness. And Newell penalised. So there's the summing up of the situation with some 12 minutes to go. Cook, and back from Cribbley, another of the former Liverpool players. And really, Brentford's players would be hoping that they'd be cheering. But it's almost as if the Brentford thousands that have come here, a short journey north to Wembley. They can't really believe that their team are trailing, but they are, and here's Aspinall taking on Murray. Castles needs interchange with Kamara. Now, possibilities here for Brentford. Kamara's gone on through the middle, Cook away on the far side, Salmon arriving as well, and Castles ignored the other options. Fired for goal. It's the blue flags that are being waved. Roy of the Freight Rovers, that's Roy Tunks, the goalkeeper whose performance in the Northern Area final was so crucial. Eight minutes left. Brentford badly in need of a touch of inspiration, perhaps a moment of good fortune. I think realist like Frank McClintock is beginning to think that it's a defeat at Wembley again for him. But here's Bullivant. And that's an interesting ball for Murray. And Roberts hustling in at the near post. Tunks made sure it was his. Eddie Lyons nearest the camera, the Brentford trainer, part-timer now at the age of 65. But so committed to the club. They say they see even more of him now than they did when he was on the full-time staff. And part of the appeal of this competition is that people like Eddie Lyons, who have put so much into the game, can enjoy the Wembley experience with their club. It might not have a happy ending for him, but you can be sure that he wouldn't have missed it for the world.